Hey everyone, welcome back to Microsoft 365 in Practice. Today we're covering one of my favorite topics, and that's SharePoint and Microsoft 365 training. I got into this business through a training school. I don't know if you know that, but I was originally a trainer, and we had many people coming to learn SharePoint, and soon we discovered, this was back in 2004, that people needed help with the consulting side as well. Didn't look back. So let me share some of the techniques that I use to create effective training tailored for small businesses and nonprofits. I'm going to show you how to customize your training materials to keep your team engaged and make the training effective without breaking the bank. I've got some time-tested tips on using pre-built PowerPoint slides and custom content to make your training sessions engaging. So whether your team is new to Microsoft 365 or upskilling, stay tuned. Let's see if we can pass on some tips and tricks to make you get more out of your training dollar. And don't forget to like and subscribe and get that notification bell for more practical tips. Okay, what you're seeing on the screen here is one of my standard Microsoft 365 SharePoint training slide decks. So I'm doing a training for a nonprofit tomorrow. And I've took about a half an hour to prep. Now, as you may know, especially if you're a trainer, usually we estimate 6 hours of preparation for 1 hour of training. Yes, training, good training, takes a lot of time to prepare. So templates, yes, that's one of the things I live by, makes it a lot easier. So what we do is we use a fairly generic slide deck here that I built out over time and improved every time I use it. And then we train using the client's Microsoft 365 environment. That's right, we use the SharePoint Sites and Pages slide deck, customized to the need of the client slightly. And the main thing is we get into their environment, and when we build in the client's environment. Usually I start with a sandbox site, so always recommend you have a sandbox for testing and training. And all I'm talking about here is a SharePoint site that or a collection of sites where you allow people to go and play, to try out the listen libraries, create pages, post news, whatever they need to do, and give it a place for them, give them a place to practice. So we call it the sandbox, but you call it the playground or the testing and training site or something more formal. So this is an example of the PowerPoint. And let me just slide you through it. Notice some of these are hidden slides. So I'll hide slides before the presentation. Here's the workshop. Notice using smart art. Now, a lot of times we will be delivering these trainings online using Teams, right? I do pretty much everything over Teams now, remote work. Yes, I'm in Mexico right now. And you may be doing the same. So remember to use animations where you can engage people a little bit more, catching their eye, keeping them interested so that they don't wander off and start checking their email or what's happening across the hall. Oftentimes, you don't know what they're up to on the other end. So you have to be as engaging as you can. Keep it crisp. Keep your voice modulation different. Speed it up, slow it down, change volume, do whatever you can to keep it interesting. Pauses are good too. Now look, if I go into the slideshow and go from the current slide, here's a simple example. Click, 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 click. I'm using a simple SmartArt animation to make it a little bit more interesting. I see I've got to fix this slide a little bit. It's overlapping. Change the font. And the other thing, notice, I don't know if you noticed that came up in a window. Let me just show you that again. So notice this is a PowerPoint window. I can move it around. I can use it as, you know, half of the screen if I want, that sort of thing. So do use PowerPoint window like that when you are presenting and doing demos at the same time. This is a demo-rich presentation. I'm going to be bringing up the client's SharePoint site. So having this as a window is much easier because PowerPoint likes to take over the screen, right? So keep it animated. Let me just go into the slideshow mode here again, and you'll see that I've animated almost everything. So let's bring these bullets in bit by bit. Now, this is a bullet-rich presentation. I don't always recommend that, but I leave these PowerPoints behind for the client, so I want them to have all the data on the slide. Bullets and PowerPoints aren't always the way to go. Now notice I've got some slightly different color and some pictures. This didn't take a lot. I'm using the insert stock image capability here and the design mode in PowerPoint to create a nice looking cover slide. And now we get into context. This slide in particular is one you can grab and use this information. Take a look at the Economic Times article here. And this catches people's attention. People start nodding when they go, oh, wow, and not nodding off, but actually agreeing with what you're saying. 25% of their time searching for information to do their jobs. This slide is served me well. Now, why do we even bother building an internet? So give people context, give them the background, and then, oh, I'm not even going to assume that they know what Microsoft 365 is. I'm going to give them the context and the concepts. What is it? Okay, so give them that context, ground up. Sometimes they'll know, and you'll say, okay, no problem. I'm just going to give this quickly to make sure we're all on the same page. Again, animation. This is not a fancy slide. It's a fairly basic slide, and it's using shapes and a little bit of animation. So we go through what, why, and then we remind them a few little tips. Oh, there's value here already. Guess what? You, as long as you can go to office.com on a web browser and you know your email address and password, you are in the office. People go, oh, wow, really? That's handy. No, not everybody knows this. Some people do. And then what about the tools that come with 365? This is always impressive. And this is where I may bring up the 365 window. And there, remember their site, and I'll click on the app launcher in the top left and show them all the apps that are available to them. And they'll be, oh, I didn't know there was so much there. So sometimes people don't know what they don't know. So let's get them excited about the possibilities that the tools they already own that they could start using. Oh, there's a bookings tool. Oh, Outlook on the web. Oh, Power Automate and Power Apps. Yeah, we could talk about those. So we sort of drill in on that, talk to them a bit more here, and then into SharePoint. So again, from the general to the specific, via internet, Microsoft 365, SharePoint, you'll see how this goes. So then we're going into some SharePoint stuff. What is it? Different types of sites. Hub sites is an important concept for most of my clients. Some I'll hide this because it's just too complex. I'm actually going to hide this slide for this client. They don't need to know. Oh, there's some animation again. Okay, so use those animations. Then now more specific, SharePoint pages and parts. Now you could talk about lists and libraries first and then pages. I choose to do it this way because I'm going to show them how to add lists and libraries to the pages later. So this is really about what is a page, and then what is a news page? It's kind of special, right? And then here's the first demo. Let's look at it. Quick demo. Notice I didn't animate the demo slide. That's because I take this and I move it over to my other monitor. Yes, you should have a second monitor. I'll move it over to my other monitor, or I'll split my screen so that I can refer to this while I do the demo, keep me on track, and keep them knowing what's coming up. So creating sites, pages, editing the home pages, creating news page, links. Great. Then we get into SharePoint lists and libraries, and there's not much more to this. So we talk about lists. What is a list? What can you do with it? This slide has been following around for about 20 years. Defining lists like spreadsheets, rows and columns, items and metadata. And then libraries. So this is actually a kind of a tongue-in-cheek one, because libraries, we go, oh, it's this thing, and then, oh, it's all the exact same data as the list one. because, yeah, it's a special kind of list that focuses on documents. So we kind of have fun with it there. I do throw a few jokes in when I can, tasteful jokes, you know. Views are really important. We talk about views. We talk about permissions. This is the how, who can do what to what slide, which we always go who can do what to what, back up and start again. Talk about who can do what to what, lists, libraries. And we talk about the permissions that way. And then there's a demo again. So I'm not going to do the demo for you. That's it. So one of the last pieces here is really putting the rubber to the road, adding lists and libraries to the site pages. So we'll actually go back and edit one of the site pages we demoed, and we'll surface a list or a library on the site where it lives. And again, this will be in their sandbox. They can go back and play with it later. If you want to make this extra effective, then you do it hands-on style. So often my clients sort of don't have time to do all that training stuff. So they go ahead and do a demonstration style. And they'll record it. We always record the training and they can watch it later. But if you want to do hands-on, then you go through these exercises, you demo it, and then you ask them to do it. This is more difficult web-based. You can't see them struggling and people often won't speak up. So you do need to check in. And one trick is to have your attendee list and go, Bob, how are you doing? Have you managed to create that list? And Mary, have you created that list? And go around that way. Because if you just say, hey, is anybody having any issues? Usually you get radio silence. So pay attention to all of that. Hopefully that's useful for you. And I do cover some of this in my SharePoint in Practice book. And if you get the SharePoint in Practice Intranet Build Toolkit, you'll be able to download, there's 4 or 5 PowerPoint slide decks, very similar to this one, that come with the book. So hopefully that's helpful for you. Please post in the comments any ideas or questions you might have. And happy SharePointing. We'll get back to you real soon.